Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vidhyashri Kamath, Consultant Obstetrician, Gynaecologist and Laparoscopic Surgeon at KMC Hospitals, Mangalore. Pregnancy-induced hypertension is one of the most common medical problems we encounter in pregnancy. It accounts to about 8 to 10% of all pregnant women. Now, is this a cause of concern? Most of the times, pregnancy-induced hypertension isn't always dangerous, but at times it could cause potential serious complications to the health of the mother as well as the developing baby. If a pregnant woman develops a blood pressure reading of more than 140 by 90 millimeters of mercury on two different occasions at any time in the pregnancy, then we call it pregnancy-induced hypertension. What are the risk factors for the development of pregnancy-induced hypertension? First-time pregnancy, that is getting pregnant for the first time itself, is a risk factor. IVF pregnancy, history of hypertension in the previous pregnancy, family history of PIH, pregnancy with twins and triplets, that is multiple pregnancy, being obese or overweight and inadequate physical activity itself is a risk factor. Pregnant mothers who have diabetes, renal disorders and autoimmune diseases are some of the risk factors for the development of PIH. What are the different types of hypertension in pregnancy? The first is the gestational hypertension, in which the blood pressure increases after 20 weeks of pregnancy and mostly it comes back to normal post-delivery. The second is the preeclampsia, where along with hypertension there is protein in the urine. These are the pregnancies which need to be monitored to prevent potential complications to the mother and the baby. The third is the chronic hypertension or pre-existing hypertension, where the pregnant mother would have had hypertension even before she got pregnant. Ideally, we need to do preconceptional counseling to optimize their health before they get pregnant. What are the complications of pregnancy-induced hypertension? If the BP is not under control, there could be maternal and fetal complications. Maternal complications could be eclampsia, where along with hypertension there is convulsion, or HELLP syndrome, wherein there is serious blood and liver problems. In rare instances, because of the impairment of the blood flow to brain and kidney, there could be stroke and renal failure as well. Coming to the fetal complications, there could be low birth weight because of the increased resistance of blood flow to the uterus and the placenta. The baby will not get enough oxygen and nutrients, resulting in low birth weight of the baby. Preterm delivery. If the BP is not under control and your obstetrician foresees certain complications to the mother and the baby, she may end up terminating the pregnancy, resulting in a preterm delivery.